Hello there. You've probably seen that Project Shadowglass video going around, where a guy managed to get almost fully stable pixels in 3D. If not, the guy deserves some support. The video is in the description. He mentioned that a good magician never reveals his tricks, but as a wizard, I'm gonna show my approach to the 3D pixel art effect.
My first try was to downsample the scene using points. I managed to get this the dig look, which I for sure dig, but the flickering was there despite making a custom downsampler. I spent some time thinking about it, and I'm not sure that 3D pixels are really possible, however, our eyes can be fooled. Notice how rotating the camera doesn't change the image at all. That's because I'm surrounded by 6 renderings of the scene. In other words, the trick is simply to use a cube map. But we still have a problem with flickering when we move, and I don't know if there's any simple way of completely eliminating it. To minimize it, you must avoid thin geometry in your scene and use aggressive LUTs in your texture sampling. You can also use fog or even depth blur to hide high frequency details. And finally, you can do what I did and sample the scene using 2 cube maps for interpolation. Alright, let's see how to set this up. I'll use Godot, but you can do the same in other engines. Start by adding a node 3D to the scene and add another node 3D as its child. That will be your cube map. Fill it with 6 subviewports and, for each viewport, set the resolution to a low square resolution and add cameras. Rotate the cameras so each camera faces a different axis, then duplicate the cube map. Add a subviewport container to your scene with another subviewport and place your main camera into it. Attach a script to your cube map controller. The script is pretty simple. Declare the shader material that will receive the cube map textures, a controllable float, a player or a camera, your cube map nodes, and 2 arrays to store the cube map viewports. Fill those arrays with the viewports. And we can move to the process method, which will position each camera in each viewport to the same position as the main camera and to an offset position. We do this offset sampling to reduce aliasing. It is a form of supersampling. Then, all this code do is to pass the viewport textures into the shader material. Okay, now we need a shader material, a shader, and a quad in front of our camera to render our final image to. Add a quad mesh in front of your main camera. Create a new shader and assign it to a new shader material. Then assign the shader material to your quad. Set the render modes of your shader to the following. Create some variables to control it. And declare uniforms to receive the cube map textures from our script. Create a method for converting a direction into a UV coordinate. And a method to blend the cube map faces. This is optional, but you can have a copy of that method with a slight offset to generate some anti-aliasing. Then grab your view direction in world space and use it to sample the cube maps. Quantize and mix them to generate the final color. I'm also doing an accumulation motion blur in the shader, but that's not necessary, so I won't teach you this unless I get enough requests in the comments. That's it. Tweak the values to your liking. I will also show you how to improve the colors. Games like Sonic 3 and Echo the Tides of Time are masterpieces to me, because of how beautifully they've used their limited color palettes. Naturally, I've been trying to make my games look good while keeping the nostalgic pixelation. My game Sepulchron is something I've been working on in my free time. It is a puzzle roguelike inspired by point-and-click games and with lots of physics interactions. I wish this could be my full-time job, but it's too bad that we all have bills to pay, hey? That being said, I've already started planning my next game for when I release Sepulchron. I would love to hear your opinion, as it will use the same art style I just showed you in this video how to make. It will be an RTS along the lines of StarCraft meets MS-DOS, Diggers and Fear and Hunger. You will gather resources and try to survive on brutally hostile alien planets, all in that gritty 80s sci-fi 3D pixel art style. As a multiplayer game, killing other players is encouraged, but the alien challenges themselves are so brutal that fighting another player would be a high-risk move. The game will likely be called Solstygian. You will command your forces from a god's eye view with Fog of War, or dive down into a third-person unit perspective to collect resources whenever you choose. Okay, enough sidetracking. Let me know what you think of my game idea, and let's get back to colors. Here I'm applying a lookup table, or LUT, so I can efficiently sample from a color palette. And as a bonus, I can even interpolate between LUTs in case I want to have better control of my day-night cycle colors. To use a lookup table is very easy. Take a few screenshots of your game and paste them into Photoshop, then add a neutral lookup table next to them. Tweak the image colors and curves until you are satisfied, and select the Save for Web option. Here you can choose between various color levels and palettes. The more colors you add, the less it will look like vintage graphics. The less colors you use, the more it will flicker. Once you are satisfied, save it and crop the lookup table. Import it as a textured 3D in Godot, and modify your shader to sample from it instead of quantizing. Be careful with HDR. You might have to use a tone mapper. I'm using a simple log compression, but you can also use Asus Filmic AGX or whatever you prefer. Finally, you can dither your sky. The less colors you are using, the more explicit the dithering patterns will be. Just use a procedural sky and apply debanding. Or program a sky shader yourself with some dithering. I have a tutorial on sky shaders you may follow. It uses noise to deband, but you can modify it to use dithering.
I guess that's all for today. Subscribe if you want to know more about Sepulchron, Solstygian, or future videos on shader programming. If you want to support me, the best you can do is wishlist Sepulchron on Steam. That's how you can help me release it and move on to Solstygian. Also, please leave a comment. I really want to hear from you. When we are developing a game, we tend to get lost in it and we grow used to its little quirks.